course.
That symbol. It looks like a variant of the Leaden Key's insignia.
I'll do this.
You went into the jungle for animal hides, I say, and found yourself in an empty clearing. Akira, the clearing was empty, I say. You asked no questions. You turned around and retraced your steps back to your ship, where it was safe. Not if you cannot listen. If you came to blunt my teeth with chatter, try to keep it short. You have an audience with me. Ruasare doesn't waste time on outsider vagrants. Deeper? Deeper how? There are many eyes on you, outsider. Use your time in Oryokuiki wisely. Rosare will be expecting you inside. Seeing as you've earned your way up from nuisance to guest, find me if you feel like trading.
I'll handle this.
Kira, what now? You're in luck. I am the only one on the island who trades with outsiders. Akira, what now? Do not eat this. It is infested. The wood-strangling wasp planted its larvae in this Kuiki. I will alert the others. Do not eat it unless you want insects to burrow through your windpipe and hollow you out from the inside.
I'll take care of this.
Keep out of my way, outsider.
Maybe the spear's a gift for us?
Silence. The outsider must leave. Oryokuiki will not be parceled off and bought with foreign lies.
Ruasare would never let that happen. Where is your confidence in our Ranga?
You are the problem. We do not track dirt in our home.
We are no better than the outsiders if our Mataru act like inhospitable savages. Where is the courtesy and welcome of the Wahaki?
If you have such love for outsiders, let this one speak for himself. You are not the first to speak in honeyed words while caressing a hidden blade. If the outsider turns on us, I say I will drag you through Tangaloa's maw with me. For all our sakes, may I be proven wrong.
On behalf of those who remember our manners, welcome to Oreo Koiki. When it strikes Rusari's fancy that we should sleep under one roof, we do so vigorously. Some think I influence her judgment, but they have the wrong of it. My back is too fragile for the weight of authority, I say. Ikira, I say circumstances have made us rough around the edges. Outsiders come with cannons, nets, torches. They do not come to talk. We safeguard any land that the trading companies have not stolen out from under Anakaza's throne. The islands will fall if the tribes do not recall our past and Ngadi's covenant. Ikira, just so. For this, she gave us the power to shape her domain. If we fail in our charges, the birthright of the Huana disappears. The Wahaki remember this. The Kahanga? They forget. We lost much of ourselves when Cataclysm scoured the Deadfire. Somewhere among the islands, there's a place where we... There is Ukaizo, a place where the Huana can find themselves again. Ask. I am pleased to be making a new friend. She is our Ranga, and the strength of our tribe. I have never seen her without a mouthful of Koiki. Even in battle, she wears a bandolier of fruit. A spirited, passionate, and very hungry woman is my Rusari.
I'll handle this.
Akira, what now?
Did you notice their face paint?
Keep out of my way, outsider!
That mural. That's the same headdress Deos wore. Her face paint. You don't suppose...
I am the Ranga of this tribe, and will not hesitate to send your soul through Tangaloa's maw if you threaten my people.
You have the gift of our hospitality during this audience. Do not abuse it.
But will our hospitality be returned?
Embeta softened his heart against outsiders. Akira, I will hear this one. Outsiders do not come to Oreo Kuiki unless they want something. Akira, a good reason. You are knowing that the purchase of foreign slaves is allowed in the Dead Fire? To buy and sell kith is the work of monsters. These slavers hunt the waters around Oreo Kuiki. Like cowards, they shy away from the deeper jungle. They steal my people from their fishing boats and sell them like pigs at auction. Where is Onikaza to stop them? Someone must teach them the meaning of Oaxaca vengeance, I say. Could this be true? What say? If those parasites drew their final breaths, I would hear of it. While Onikaza plays at diplomacy, we are the spear in the guts of our enemies. I have come to expect troubling news from outsiders. Today is no different, but at least you bring me a tale for my grandchildren. You come to us in time of need. The tribe will know you as a friend. Go in peace. The hospitality of the Oaxaca is yours. Respect our ways, and cause no trouble.
Outsider, unlike Barapo, I do not use this as a term of offense, I say. We do not see many visitors on Oreo Kuiki. Those who come, seldom leave. They come asking our Ranga to show her belly in surrender. Instead, she shows them their guts at the end of a spear. Ugh, how he fills our home with the stink of his burnt offerings. A rational mystic burns incense or candles, but Burapo burns Kuiki, rotten meat, and bundles of hair. Nothing is spared his flame if it appeases the gods. A valuable lesson about animancy, I say. There is quality and there is cheap, but never both. The rust bucket does not follow my instructions and ignores my command words. I am appreciating the offer, but it is better if I learn how to operate my degraded friend. I would be a poor host if the ironclad thing decided to remove your skin. Akira, I can see that well enough from here. Here, the command words. They do me little good.
Come no closer, outsider.
Your Excellency, I come to warn your people. Your presence among these ruins is an affront to the gods. You must remove yourself, lest you face the gods' wrath. The timeline of the gods is not for mortals to understand. But even their patience shall wear thin, especially after this warning. Your people cling tightly to their history. But where are these designs among your arts? Where is the carved Adra in your wooden huts? These places were not built by the Huana, but by an ancient people from a distant land. I have seen your murals, and I know that you will recognize this. It was my people who built these places, and now I come before you bearing their warning.
Why do you stare so? What say? If those parasites drew their final breaths, I would hear of it. While Onakaza plays, I have come to I will hear you, outsider. I know only that they clang and clash like foreign names. The Wahaki show outsiders that we know their deceitful face. My ancestor knew this face well. She recalled its every hateful curve to the Wahaki histories. We wear the bone-white grimace of our enemies and take power from it.
What's this? I'll handle this.
Back there, with the chieftain. Did you see something?
Dead!
Blood and rock!
Aye. Yes?
That's like what he told the Glanfathans. I bet he didn't expect they'd kill him for it. Would have loved to see the look on his face.
Then the Wahaki are the painted masks. They've been serving the Leaden Key's interests for 2,000 years without even knowing it. Though not, it seems, in the way Theos intended.
Now that's just wrong.
Belief is a curious thing. Once, the Wahaki believed they were guarding themselves against the Ingwithians, Theos's people. Yet over time, they became hostile toward all outsiders. It's not just that the Wahaki misread Theos's original message. It fundamentally changed them. They went from being a large and well-connected tribe to a much smaller one defined by isolationism.
You see all the ninian I suffer from this lad? Right short is rattling around in his noggin.
You know me too well. I've been chasing the Leaden Key, trying to undo the harm they've caused. But what if I'm only making matters worse? Might I be to blame? Have I made a grievous mistake in getting involved? I suppose that's true. It's an intimidating thought, but a heartening one, too. Perhaps it was naive to think I could dismantle a 2,000-year-old organization in a single lifetime. But it's worth it to try. Indeed not. I've got Isselmir for that. The strange thing is, this whole ordeal has given me some sympathy for Theos. Not that I condone his actions, of course. But I can't imagine he thought he'd destroy an entire generation either. Well, not in the beginning, anyway. What I mean to say is, he thought he was doing the right thing. Even at the end. I worry things aren't so simple. Still, perhaps you're right. At any rate, it'll be a relief to move forward. It was always too comfortable to leave the hard decisions to others. To simply follow along. I only wonder now what sort of decision you'll have to make when we finally confront Aethys. A reasonable point. Anyway, thank you. This has lifted a great burden from my shoulders.
Visitor, I hope your time on Orioko.
Keep out of my way, outsider.
Looks like trouble.
Charge!
Mad dog will hunt. Moeth, Ixi, Alma.
Take that, lava. Beyond seek.
That's very helpful.
You were saying?
can I do you?
Yes?
Thank you.
Look at that little bear belly.
It is a bad omen to have a priestess so young.
Age is no assurance of wisdom. Remember Anna?
Still your tongue. Amira's winds will surely carry your words.
I don't like this, Watcher. Is there nothing we can do to help?
You look at me for what? To watch me shrivel up in the sun? If only my brain and belly had coordinated, I say I would have tried sooner. Keho hates me because I insult his puny catches of fish. All he does is weigh down his boat. For this, he accuses me. Keho says I was skulking by the drying hut north of the Ranga's home. Ikira, this is so. I would have taken the Kohiki, but it was already gone. It is said the Roparu share one empty stomach. Blame any of them, I say. The tribe dries me out like jerky because I am hated, not because I am a Kohiki thief.
Ruana was wise to bring us here. A year, and still foreigners never attack.
But our food dwindles. Better to...
I don't know how you and the Watcher sleep, carrying all those souls around.
Well, I do sleep better when the Watcher's around, that's for sure.
Does it suddenly feel warm in here to you?
See what we found.
Yes. Hello. Whatever you need, I can help. What say? But can who speak through a false blowhole? Prove it. Show me the real traitor. Gatti's lamp shine on you. I say Tamau is the only one selfish enough to do this.
Ikira, that is no work of mine. Though I want to see you lose a finger to the crabs digging up the rest.
I say I'm beyond finished. For this, I'll feed you to Ngati myself. With respect, it is not for you to question how I protect the tribe and appease the gods. Unless you think someone else is to blame. For what do you meddle in? Tamara goes nowhere. The gods are patient, I say.
What say? You are new to Tikiwara?
Only the Tamau has slept like a fat tortoise, while the rest of us chew on reeds to fool our bellies. Ikira, no one could be less surprised. Tamau had this coming. For what do you come to me, then? Guilty or no, being tossed to the waves is what Tamau deserves. I have no tears for him. He complained until the Ranga gave him my finest mats, and then left him out for the sport of beasts. Let the gods sort him. The tribe has challenges enough without Juana eating from each other's plates. You should know this, or do you walk with your eyes closed? I see your feet will not let you stay in one play. I weave in the afternoon, of course. All that I earn goes back. Ikira, the Mataru get the best of.
Yes, hello. Whatever you need, I can help. Yes. Hello. What?
I see your feet will not let...
You ever long for the simple life, soldier?
Nah, where I'm from, sometimes the simple life comes knocking on your door with nooses and pitchforks.
For what do you follow me? I stole the Koiki. Not Tamao. Ruanu would have us waste our last Koiki on a ceremony to the gods. I say the seeds must be harvested and planted. So I hide them by the shore, where the sun warms the sand just so. And I wait. Ikira, do you cultivate? Koiki is tough, stubborn. It does not surrender without a fight. I let Amira's hot breath warm the heart of the seeds, and tell them to grow. Ruanu would not understand. A Kuwaru like me is no farmer. It is not my place to decide what is harvested. But if I can spring life from the Koiki seeds, then we have a chance to feed the tribe on a new crop. At least... what tribe still lives by the time the fruit grows? What say? He has stolen, insulted us, even hurled insults at the gods. He is no innocent, I say. If... Ikira, but say nothing. If Ruanu takes back the Koiki, we will grow nothing else in time to sustain the tribe. I beg of you. For the good of the tribe, let Tumau meet the gods that the rest of us might eat again.
Yes, hello. Whatever you need, I can help. Kara, this is true? Why would Rangi do this? What say? He thinks a weaver knows better than Duranga what to do with our fruit? Two traitors. But only one deserves death this day.
I could never eat a dwarf. For what?
Play along! I choose the belly, rich and fatty.
We are Reparu.
Welcome back, welcome back. It is a pleasure to see you once again. Tell me, how is the sailing? Smooth? Nothing to delay your expedition, I hope. How might I assist you? Ah, how exciting. Let's see here. Goodness, that's not what I was expecting. And so close to Porto Maggi. You've done wonderfully. Oh, this book will be the best thing since Cassini's adventures, and that was all romantic rubbish. Here, your pay, my friend. We're only getting started, of course. Tikawara next, I think. How does that strike you? It's a little Juana village out to the southeast. Three islands this time, all nameless and unloved. They form a little triangle around Tikawara, if you squint. I'll be waiting.
Tell me.
What can I do you for?
I'm here.
What can I do you for?
I'm listening.
Yes?
Welcome back. Look at...
So she asked him what he calls that trick, and he says the Consuelo. You the one causing trouble in Carter's neighborhood? Your smoke and mirror ghosts do not impress Calezia, and they do not scare Carter.
Sorry, Valian names all sound the same to me. Which one is the pretty wolf?
You'll know soon enough. Zamar has money problems. Carter has solutions. The little man doesn't know how to count his coins. Carter heard a newcomer was talking with Zamar. Tell the shipwright to accept Carter's deal before he suffers another setback. The coin is gone. I'm ale for Carter's friends and food for Carter's wolf. Macasita gets the rest. Zamar can keep Principi's ships afloat. Carter tires of seeing his family sailing derelict wrecks. Celetia, the throat!
Welcome back. Look.
news worth telling. Best news I've heard since I arrived on this rock. What of Captain Rodora? Has she sobered up yet, or do we need to shake her by her ankles? Robbed? Abaddon's fist! Someone's feeling bold to prey on a captain in Queen's berth. Matters being what they are, Redora's commission is yours, if you can afford it. That'll be the Iron Thunderer. A cannon well deserved of her name. Maybe she doesn't stand up to Rauatai standards, but she's got heart.
Same could be said of the Wahaki tribe, and look what happened to them.
For 1,000 pyres, she'll crack a hull, scour a sail, or splinter a deck like an imp with something to prove. But your friend's mouth has raised the price by 500. Well, I'm here if you ever change your mind.
I'll see that you get your money's worth, Captain.
Your vessel will spit fire like a worm with a belly full of fire kelp.
Thank you. My time is free to give.
Well, is it done? Is the Bardotto family dealt with?
Martino, to arms!
Cross the lad!
Lava!
Yes?
Yeah.
Hey.
Hmm?
Yes? I know just it's done.
We got trouble, folks.
You see that?
Watch your aim.
We got trouble, folks.
It's done. I know Jet Sam.
So, it's finished at last. Atello Valera is dead, and you have your reward. It will be refreshing to engage with accomplished foes for a change. You have done all I asked for. Take satisfaction in that. If you'll excuse me, I must see to some personal matters.
Mother speaks highly of you.
Her trust is not
even
easy to
earn. Even with the Valeras gone, my family is not without enemies.
I confess, I take full responsibility for the death of Othello Valera.
Mother! My little privateer, you have news for me? Belfetto, a fitting test of your skills and a promising beginning for us both. It goes without saying that I have more work for you if you have the space for more coin. The company is always eager to hunt pirates. My contacts have one by the name of Veen in their spyglass. Veen is a Vithrak. If such things matter to you, gets in your head, they say. Gilarde, you can catch up to Veen as he sails the Dhow reckless far east of Neketaka, past the Kuaurikuhu Islands, no doubt thinking himself beyond our reach.
Welcome back. Governor Alvari will see you.
Ah, good, you're back. I hope. Ah. Before you get too far on the way, I think you ought to come with me. Director Castol will want to hear from you in person.
Alvari tells me you were kind enough to look into this business on Pococahara for us. I hope you bring good news. De Veras? Incredible. What fortune we have had to find a watcher. And Adra, vein of that size, will do much to allay our investors' concerns.
And the crew?
Beza and the others. A sorry end for such dedicated individuals. How very fortunate that you lived to tell their tale. I believe I can take things from here, Alvari. Agrasima. The Watcher and I have more business to discuss. Oh, and do pay the man for his trouble first. I thought it best I speak with you face to face. Watchers are not so numerous here in the Deadfire, especially those of such storied backgrounds as yourself. I'd read much about your exploits alongside the Crucible Knights in Defiance Bay, their little experiments. And I think that we are, each of us, in a position to offer each other something that we cannot find elsewhere. The Valian Trading Company has had a presence on this island for nearly a century now. We have the greatest fleet on the seas, the support of the richest men and women in the world. What can the Royal Deadfire Company offer? A soldier's wages, so that you can elevate the fortunes of a distant king? And the queen? A place in the Kahanga tribe among all the rest of these neglected people. You've lived outside the caste system all these years. Are you eager to return to it? I can give you money, fame, certainly. But the men and women of the company, we set our aims high. And if I only wanted to offer you work as an Ardra inspector, I would have let Alvari deal with you. The Valian Trading Company has maintained an outpost here in Nekataka for nearly a century now. It was only 2 years ago that we discovered the effects of Luminous Ardra with the aid of our animancers and several watchers. Flaune Alet has continued to study the potential of Luminous Ardra in all manner of advances. Why content ourselves to sell all this Ardra as a luxury when we might use it to change the world? But of course you understand all of this. Alet sent word of your involvement in her latest experiment. A very dramatic first attempt, I hear. Though, Alet has a tendency to gloss over details. But, I want to hear it from you. Ah, separating watchers from their souls is very much not what we want. A pity. Alet was having some luck with some of the volunteers. Short leaps, admittedly. A near-death experience does little to recommend Alet's efforts. I am glad you are in one piece, Watcher. We are in the early days of Alet's research. Flawed as this outing was, there is promise there. This is only the start, you know. The very dawn of a new age of discovery. But just imagine. Imagine if we could transport goods and people more quickly than any vessel or horse. Cure every kind of ailment. Perhaps cure disease altogether. We'll extend our lifespans by decades, maybe even centuries one day. This has all been the work of a single outpost. I want there to be a dozen outposts, 100 animancers working together to better our lives. Look at what we have left behind. Old Velia is a battlefield at constant war with itself. But the Republics have risen from that past. We can rise farther still. And in doing so, we will raise all of Aora with us. Yes, but achievable, I think. I may not live to see it, but I will see the groundwork done. But I've said enough. Too much, I think. There will be more experiments to come. Until then, I have a more grounded task I need assistance with. Nothing that should put your spirit in any danger. Nekataka sees its share of smuggling. I doubt that would surprise anyone. But we've learned of a particular exchange that will have more dire effects than a few spoiled Hawana peasants. There is a Royal Deadfire Company official by the name of Quarno who has been meeting in secret with one of the Principi. I do not believe he works with the approval of his masters. He meets with a Captain Tola, a known pirate and smuggler. I hope I don't have to tell you that an alliance between a crooked royal official and the Principi is not the kind of trouble any of us need. I have a woman, Britza, waiting. operating in the luminous bathhouse in Periki's Overlook. The smugglers do business there, and she has kept an eye on things. I promise to send assistance. Find her, and she will tell you what she knows. Telling you amounts to much the same, no? Someone has to put a stop to things.
Good thing that someone is us. Raotian black powder is worth its weight in Adra out here.
Excellent. Meeting you has been a stroke of luck, Watcher. I'll await your report.
This room's typhus already. Must you crowd it further?
Thank you.
this is where we part ways. For the moment. Asura will want me to report in alone. Sorry, it's company business. I might not be back for a few days on account of this. I'm supposed to handle this one alone. I won't ask you to come along or get involved. When I said I won't ask, what I mean is you aren't invited. This is a one-woman, one-bird kind of job. You've got Shodi to keep you company. You two play nice.
You stay safe, you hear, Ma? Come back in one piece.
Go have fun. Chase a god, save an island. Do what you do best, Captain. And you as well. Just don't have too much fun without us.
Pyro cheat, I'm telling you.
It's impossible to cheat at Hazatoa.
Clear skies. That explains the rumors the Valians are scaling up in Queen's Birth. I'd hoped you would stop them. They'll press gang the locals and tear Pococahara apart. Once they're done, they'll leave behind a wrecked island and a tribe dependent on their resources. Nevertheless, I'm more interested in reports the storms around the islands have cleared. What do you know of this? Even if this isn't the outcome we'd wanted for Pococahara, your observation is infinitely more valuable. Take this, and remember it the next time we call on you. We'd long suspected something unnatural was behind the storms, but we had little evidence. Yes. If the storms that assail Rawatai have a similarly unnatural origin, then perhaps they too can be stopped. And if that's the case, then there's more work to be done. Work that you might be able to help with. After all, somebody has to keep the peace in these tumultuous times, no? In any case, Hazanui Karu has a matter that could use your help. Her office is on the main floor behind the large double doors. It's most conspicuous. He acts like he's gonna do one.
Good to see you again.
Asura tells me you tamed the storms of Pococahara. Makes a person wonder what kind of secrets lie in Andra's mortar. What kind of explorer are you? Don't tell me you've never gazed at a horizon and wondered at what lies beyond. Or seen a no trespassing sign as a challenge. That's the spirit. Rautai's storms have made us who we are as a nation. Hardy, driven, inventive. But they've also held us back. Forced our people to seek resources and livelihoods far from our homes and families. Imagine how much more we could achieve if we could control those storms. Why not? The storms there cannot be natural. Not when they are so ferocious, so constant. And your exploits at Pococahara suggest that something else may be behind them. But enough of that for now. Noticed that, did you? Saltpeter is one of our chief resources at Rautai. And we believe in putting resources to use. Now you can see why we didn't want the Valians nosing around our fort. There's an understatement. The trouble in Hosongo forced us to send additional ships back to Rautai to make up for shortfalls. And storms at home have delayed another portion of our fleet. This leaves us short-handed here. We're due to collect a special shipment for delivery to our port at Sayuka. We've contracted with a captain named Widla. Meet her, complete the trade, and take the cargo to Sayuka. Fleetmaster Okaya is overseeing the development of some special projects there. She's one of the brightest minds in Rautai, and it shows. You two will get along. Most of her work is, or should be, under wraps for now. But perhaps she can give you a taste of what we have to offer. Good sailors with a fast ship and no mind for questions. Along with half the population of this storm-tossed archipelago. Widla's agreed to meet our courier out at sea, away from the heaviest traffic. This is her payment. We've already negotiated with her. Fleetmaster Okaya will see to your compensation once you arrive with the cargo. This is the kind of job that's best completed quickly and quietly. I'm counting on your famous discretion. Clear skies.
I'll take care of this.
Your mighty fortress.
So you fell for all of Natehi's flowery talk of cultural pride. I hope your time on Nekataka as the Juana loving errand runner is profitable. Now get out of here.
Much better than wooden huts, my friend.
You cannot stand against such a force.
What can I do for you? You see anything?
feeling all maroon-like.
Something I can do?
What for, Cap?
What can I do?
Bye.
fast, Ground Filth. Why disturb Lord Admiral, eh? Eh? Not doing anything wrong. Eh? Go away. Vote! Eh? Lord Admiral has fleet. Blast filthy Ground Stink City. Start with you, eh? Get him, Cullies! This is futile!
Onward!
Bad bit of tackle, Captain.
I see you brought your pain, but you need come to ease it. Pity. It eases my pain. More than that is an awful long yarn, and they entered lightly. Lest there's anything you need.
Is this your first time to the baths?
You and I? We have a mutual friend, do we not? Good, good. A Royal Deadfire operative, Quarno, and his Principio associate, Tola, will meet tonight to discuss the details of a business arrangement.
They have bought out the entire first floor for privacy's sake. Even Ganner, their proprietor, will excuse himself. Only bathhouse attendants will be allowed to remain, to ensure their comfort. You understand? I will disguise you as a bathhouse attendant, so you might observe their meeting. With luck and some cunning, you may be able to discover the details of their special arrangement. You will not be able to take your gear, but do not worry. Should the situation get out of hand, there will be a stash of weapons hidden in one of the changing booths. But I am sure it will not come to that. Gelarde! Then you will take your disguise, and I shall take your equipment, Ak. Take this rice wine as well. Perhaps you will find use of it, eh?
What time in Langin and all this water is making me thirsty. Your face is weird. Have we met? It's probably the wine. Flatterer. I'm no queen of Nekataka, but I do all right. I captain a ship for the Principe, and the big grouchy guy back there, Quano, works for the Royal Deadfire Company. Sometimes, when he's not doing stuff on the sides. Doing stuff like selling me cannons. That's what we're celebrating. Did I mention that? You're cute. Got a good face. But even that won't get me to say any more. Now, maybe if you had some more rice wine. Has anyone ever told you you're great? Because you are really great. You should ditch this stupid bathhouse. Join my crew. I just got a bunch of fancy new cannons from Quano. We'll be the terrors of the Deadfire. It'll be fun. I'm gonna blow up some Valian trading company ships and take their Luminous Ardra. Shh, shh, shh. Don't tell anyone. No, I've already had too much.
Report to Director Castle once you've learned what you can.
already have one guest in my head. I don't need another.
Sorry, lad. Thought that chip on your shoulder were for all to see.
Do you ever have a thought and just decide to keep it to yourself?
More than you know, my dear inmate. More than you know.
Hey, Shodi. Those dreams of yours, they still getting to you?
I can deal with the dreams, for better or worse. What makes me sweat is the not knowing. What happens when I stand face to face with my God, and he reveals what he intends for me? What if it's not as I thought?
Yeah, I've had thoughts like that for a long time. Except now I'm worried about what he intends for the world.
Whatever it might be, at least we'll face it together.
Do you suppose the Hasango was a kind of vengeance for Rawatai's assistance with the Godhammer? Oh, listen to me. It all sounds perfectly mad. Perfetto, what did you discover? Diverus? That is worse than I suspected. Please, explain. Spare me no details. Madiko, our convoy routes are meant to be a well-guarded secret. I might as well have sent the Principe a letter. That is enough to work with. Agrisima, I do believe I'm going to ruin Quarno's day. Belfetto Watcher, already our partnership proves fruitful. You know, I wish you'd been around a year back. We would have left the Royal Deadfire Company in the dust. Now then, did you have a reason for coming by?
Thank you.
Ten.
Siamas, me too, man. Scallywag's ho, Cap.
Indeed. So it is you. I could not think of a reason why your ghost should haunt the Deadfire, save to haunt me. And that smacks of arrogance. Sister. Another collection of spirits? The rumor was that Cat Nua was destroyed, and you with it. Sorry to hear it. I did, in time. Once I thought I'd summoned up the words to explain what happened in the White March. None of it made much sense to the Regency, but my men stood by me. If I was mad, so were they. When the priest spoke of Aethys' return, I volunteered to come, along with a few of my men. I think the Morning Council was content to have me out of the way. That's putting it all very simply. But then, I suspect few of us have simple reasons for coming to the Deadfire. Of course, I did not think. It must be difficult to see it so changed. I don't know. I came here on a pilgrimage of a kind. Nicotaka is full of spirits. And the sea. Where to begin?
Self-loathing is a blot on the soul, Adderick. Don't make your journey through hell darker than it has to be.
You're right, of course, sister. You are a watcher still. Yet you are neither mad nor killed. It's good to see. The cure you sought, and which I was weak enough to doubt. See? There. Determination will win out every time. And now you are on to new challenges. That sword was only meant to keep you alive through your ordeal. It's fulfilled its purpose. Each missive from the Deadfire raises new tumult. Some believe our Lord restored, while others doubt. We've done penance for many long years. None of us know what forgiveness ought to look like.
It doesn't seem like Aethys has his mind on forgiveness these days.
Take care, and may the Shining God light your way.
Light of Aethys be upon you. Your friend guided you truly. Gadarion Bosch has honored me with the duty of helping his message reach all of the faithful. We answer the Shining God's call. He shows us the way and we march in his wake. Already the Vanguard prepares to make its journey, with more soon to follow. When the time is right, he will welcome our souls into his legion. Gadarion Bosch has seen it.
Just your souls then? Not your bodies?
The Shining God demands total commitment from his followers. What good is a soldier who is not willing to make the ultimate sacrifice for her cause? To walk the lighted path, one must be willing to never turn back.
Tough to walk very far without a soul. The Hollowborn, huh? Usually you'd have to stack him in a wheelbarrow and push him around.
Gadarion Bosch leads the Vanguard. They are the most righteous of the partisans. They will be the first to join the ranks of Aethys, the first to charge at his call.
Baron said something about the Vanguard. You don't think he's that dumb, do you?
The Vanguard know their own, and Gadarion Bosch knows them. Beyond that, we keep such information private.
If they know their own, what do you think they'd say to a couple new members? Can we be in the Vanguard too?
I'm afraid you cannot. The Vanguard is reserved for the most faithful among us. You have not even joined the Partisans. I agree, and Gadarion Bosch has admitted to the Vanguard all who ask to join. Unfortunately, even if I were to initiate you right now into our order, it would be too late to join the Vanguard. Their ship is docked right now in Nekataka, and set to depart at any moment.
You think he could be on it? If he left right after we did...
They won't take you, but there will be more ships to follow. Stay and learn about the Partisans of the Lighted Path.
That's a real nice offer. We'll think about it and get back to you.
For the temple.
I'll take this.
missed it. They're gonna park that thing next to Aethys and slit their own throats. I wish they'd gone ahead with it before they got Baron involved. If we can't catch it, can you promise me we'll go right now? I knew there was something I liked about you.
The others have drunk, Baron. Their souls make their way to Aethys. This isn't the time for hesitation. It's the time for faith. Come. Let us show him together.
No, 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 kid!
What is this? You aren't one of my flock. How did you get here?
Lower that. Let's talk. Your mom knew how to spot a fake. What do you think she'd say about him?
How could I know? She left me here.
What is faith if it isn't tested? These people are willed here by Aethys to challenge you. Make him proud.
I will make him proud.
Maybe he's not testing faith. Maybe he's testing if you can think for yourself.
But our faith, isn't that what the gods ask of us?
Aethys has come just as I said he would. There will be no other chances.
He must be in need to reach out to us.
Effigy's eyes, kid. You think your tiny soul's gonna change his fate? What he means is, you're probably more valuable to Aethys alive.
Tend in fields while he marches to change the world? Unlikely.
History doesn't look kindly on deserters, Bairn. Nor will your god.
Hard to blame his deserters. They got to live. Meanwhile, his last vanguard got burned right out of the world, bones and all.
I've come this far. How could I be forgiven for failing him now?
Aethys doesn't deserve your life, or even your crazy leader's. Not until he starts making some sense.
I never figured I was worthy of receiving his explanation.
It's now or never, Bairn. Will you abandon your god? Or will you come to his aid?
Come on, say something.
Adair's right. Who exactly demands this sacrifice, Bairn? Aethys or him? Beware of men who claim the authority of the gods. They often have little care for mortals.
Your thoughts be more knotty than Rauatai Riggin, lad. The farmer be speaking sense for once. Better to live for a god than die for one.
Listen to me. You gotta listen, kid. Bairn, during the Saints' War, me and my brother, we had a choice to make. It was just like this. We saw it different, he and I. He chose our god. I didn't. I'll never see him again. And I don't know where his soul is now. But I don't think Aethys was around to save it. You're gonna stay here. There's better ways to serve your god. You can build something in his honor, like I did. A town, a temple, a good life. maybe not a statue.
Aethys, forgive me.
As you wish, then. Abandon your god. For betrayal, there can be no forgiveness. You will receive not his mercy, but his justice.
Don't you got somewhere you need to be, Bosch? If you're having second thoughts, I can help you follow through.
Not a one. The Shining God will light the way.
Think he's all right? He looks a little seasick.
That would have been me. If I were stronger, it would have been me.
Lucky you weren't stronger then. The gods might have rights to our souls, but they got no right to our lives. Seems to me they'll take from you whatever's not nailed down if you let them.
I could devote my entire life to Aethys, and it would never redeem this.
For right now, let's just get you home.
Bairn.
I'm not sure what you want to talk about. I have my life. And I know it's because of you. I know I should be thanking you. But the truth is, I don't know if I want to be here now. Or what I'm supposed to be doing. And I still don't know what to say to Aethys when I meet him one day.
It should be the other way around. He's the one who owes you an explanation. You hear me, kid? He owes you.